So now what I want to do is show you how to create some blog posts for your WordPress website. And this is an individual blog post. And right at the top, you have the category name, the blog title, and then when the post was written and who wrote it. And then we'll have this featured image and then the content section. And if you want, we can add a comment section for your visitors to leave a comment. And a little bit later, I'll show you how to customize the sidebar on your blog post also. So on the blog page, this is what it's going to look like. So we'll have a list of different blog posts on the blog post page. So if you want to learn how to make this for your WordPress website, let's go back to the page that we're working on. What we want to do is go back to our WordPress website that we're making, and we can hover over new right here and click on posts, or we can go the long way, which is going to hover over our website name and then click on dashboard. And once you're back on the WordPress dashboard, to make a new blog post, what you want to do is hover over posts and click on add new. And once you're on the add new post page, making a blog post is really easy. So I'll show you how to do this once, and then you can create as many different blog posts that you want for your WordPress website on your own. So the first thing that we're going to do is type in a blog title right here. So I'll type in build something great for my first post. And then I'll come down here and I'm on the visual tab and I'll just paste in some text. And if you want, you can style this text with these buttons over here. You can hover over them to see what they do. And in this drop down, you can increase the size of your font. And you can also click on the add media button if you want to add videos or photos. So I'll let you play around with this on your own. And once you're ready, what I want you to do is come down to the bottom to the featured image section. And you want to include a featured image if you want the blog post page to have an image like this, or the blog page itself have images that show up on each of your blog posts like this. If you want that, what you have to do is include a featured image. So click on set featured image, and I'll just stay on the media library tab and select this demo image. So it's a blogpost.jpg. And then I'll click on the set featured image button and you should see the image appear down here. So you also have the option of choosing the template that you want for the page. So in this drop down, you can see there's a few different options, and I like to just use the default template because this one has the sidebar and the post that you saw on the individual blog posts. So I'm not going to change anything here, but you can if you want. And then right here, you can type in some tags for SEO purposes if you want. I don't actually do this for any of my blog posts, so I'll leave this blank. And then if you want, you can add a category name for your blog post also. But again, I'm not going to do this. And then you can just come up here, and depending on the type of blog post that you're creating, you can select the different format here. I just like to use the standard one, so that's the one that we'll use for this demo. And once you're done typing out your blog post, all you have to do is click on the publish button. So I'll click on that right now. And once the post is published, let me just go and show you what it looks like. So I'll click on view post. And once the post loads, this is what it should look like. So you can see up here, it says uncategorized. And that's because I didn't put in a category name. And then you'll have your blog title right here. And then the date that it's posted. And then who wrote the blog post. So if you want to have another author or a different name, I'll show you how to create that in just a few minutes. But first, let me show you the rest of this blog post. So you'll have your featured image right here, your content below, and then a comment section right here. And on the right-hand side, you should have a sidebar, and there should be some stuff in here right now. And this is all from default settings. So we'll go in here and customize this in just a little bit. So what I want to do now is just show you how to create a different author name and then make sure that you have the comment section below, and we'll also delete the default blog post that comes when you install WordPress. Okay, so there's a few things that we have to do before we can start customizing the sidebar over here. So let's go back to our WordPress dashboard and do that, and then I'll let you create some blog posts on your own. So what I want to do is just hover over my website name right here and click on dashboard.